Hi everyone and welcome to another video. A few days ago I posted a few videos regarding installing, upgrading and also about the performance of Windows 11 on unsupported hardware. No matter which method you use to get Windows 11 on your PC, I did notice that quite a few people have issues with Windows Secuirty, mainly after performing an upgrade from Windows 10, and from what I can find, it looks like this is not only impacting people that have upgraded on unsupported hardware. In this video, I will show you how I managed to fix this issue. The issue looks as follows. When you try to open the Windows Secuirty app, you can open it, but you get a pretty empty screen. Clicking here shows you Secuirty at a glance, but not much more. None of the other buttons seem to do anything as well. Also, when you go to Settings, Privacy and Security, Windows Secuirty, the whole Windows menu is stuck. Nothing is responding anymore and only clicking to close it works. Digging a bit into the issue on Google brought me to various similar issues. Some of them are almost identical and were also seen on Windows 10. Unfortunately, none of the fixes that I could find were helping to resolve the issue. Initially, I thought that this might be related to having upgraded to Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, on which I did a video earlier. But doing a fresh install of Windows 11 on the same hardware did end up with working Windows Secuirty, so I knew it was not hardware related. One more thing that I did notice, and I believe this is the main reason that the Windows Secuirty tools are not working. When having a look at the services, you can see that the Windows Secuirty service is not able to start. Let's get all of this fixed. Before we get started, I'd like to mention that I also have a blog, yanzi.be. You can find all the steps and commands that I will use in the video in detail over there. So if you plan to go through this, I really recommend you to get a look there. On the end of this video, I will also put a few other things that I found online and did try as well to resolve the issue. As I mentioned, they didn't work for me, but they might for you. The method that did work for me starts by downloading the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft's website. Once the ISO is downloaded, we can navigate to our Downloads folder and mount the ISO by double-clicking on it. As you can see, in my case, this created a new drive letter D, as I don't have a real CD or DVD drive connected to my PC. Now create a new folder, I called it Win11, on the desktop or anywhere else, and copy all the files from the mounted ISO to that folder. Once the copy is complete, unmount the ISO by doing a right click on the drive letter and choose Eject. In case you're running Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, like an unsupported CPU or without TPM or secure boot, there is an extra step to go through here. If you are running on fully supported hardware, you can skip it, but it shouldn't hurt. First, download an old version of apprazorrest.dll. I put a link on my blog and also in the description. Open your Downloads folder and open next to it the Win11 folder that we created and copied the files to. Navigate to the Sources folder in there. Here you can see that the same file, apprazorrest.dll, exists. This is the file that is responsible for the hardware check in the installer, so we'll replace it with an older version of Windows 10 that does not perform this check. Open the downloaded zip file and copy the DLL file from there to the Sources folder and confirm to overwrite the file. Now we are ready to launch setup.exe from the folder we created. This will run the installer for Windows 11, the same version as we have, and should fix the issue. In the first screen, click on Change how setup downloads updates and choose Not right now. We do this because we don't want that modified DLL file to be overwritten. Accept the license in the next screen and choose Install in this screen. Once you clicked Install, you will get a blue screen like the following. This will take quite some time and, as mentioned on the screen, the PC might restart a few times. After being patient, we can log in, but then we need to wait a bit more after doing so. Finally, you should end up at your desktop again. Let's test now and check if this has worked. Launching the Windows Secuirty app seems to work. This looks a lot better than before. Same applies for the Windows Secuirty settings page. Now, if we take a look at the service, we can see that the Windows Secuirty service is in a running state. That's a lot better. Hopefully, this can help you in restoring the functionality of Windows Secuirty after upgrading to Windows 11. In case this all didn't help, as I mentioned in the beginning, I did find different methods that helped for other people but not for me. I'll go through them briefly here as I try them all. First alternative is to reinstall the Windows Secuirty app. For that, open an elevated PowerShell prompt and execute the following. This seems to help for an issue which appeared in a certain insider build, but it has been fixed in the final release of Windows 11, so this was not the issue I was facing. Second alternative is similar, and it is to redeploy all Windows apps using PowerShell. Again, open an elevated PowerShell prompt and execute the following. This takes some time, but same as the previous method, this didn't help for me. The third option is to scan for corrupt system files. This method seemed to help quite some people that had exactly the same issue but on Windows 10. Open a command prompt as administrator and execute the following: sfc/scannow. Nothing was found here, and as you can guess, it also didn't help. Similarly, you can scan for component store corruption using DISM. DISM/online/cleanup-image/scanhealth. Unfortunately, no corruption was found, so this didn't really help either. And the last alternative method I found is to try to reset or repair the Windows Secuirty app. As I had a strong suspicion that the root cause was not the application itself, but rather the non-started Windows Secuirty service, I didn't think this would help, but it's easy to try. Navigate to the Windows Secuirty app in the Start menu, but do not open it. Instead, right-click on it and choose App Settings. In the Apps menu, scroll a bit down to the Reset section and try a repair or a reset. Same here, as I suspected, this didn't help me, but it might help you. Hopefully, at least one of these methods have helped you to fix the issues you're facing. If you like this video, please put a thumbs up, and if you like my content, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.